This video is going to be about setting the viewing window for a graph. And sometimes you might be given a problem like this. You've got y equals x squared minus 4x minus 165. And you've got a graphing calculator. And you're told to find an appropriate viewing window for this graph. Now, of course, what you can do is you could put this into your calculator. And then you could, actually, if you put this into your calculator as it is, and you just go to a standard window, you won't see anything. In fact, if you want to pause the video and try that, go ahead. Now, of course, what you could do is you could zoom out and you could adjust different parts of your viewing window and so on until you get it to where you want it. But sometimes it's actually simpler just to do it mathematically. So here's how we're going to do it. Okay, I've rewritten the equation and set it equal to 0. So I've got x squared minus 4x minus 165 equals 0. And then I just factored that quadratic side of it, the x squared minus 4x minus 165. And I end up finding out that x equals negative 11 and x equals 15. Okay, so you know this process. Well, remember, when I say x equals negative 11 and x equals 15, those are going to be the x-intercepts on the graph. So I know where the x-intercepts are, and they're going to be important when I want to actually find the appropriate viewing window. I'm also going to need the y-intercept, and that's very easy to find. Let's take this equation and set it back so it's equal to y. The y-intercept happens when x is 0. So if x is 0, then y equals 0 squared minus 4 times 0, both of those are just 0, minus y 165. So the y-intercept is going to be at 0, comma, negative 165. Now, I also want to know what the vertex is, because that's a significant part of the graph also. So I can use the vertex formula to find that. Remember, the vertex is, the formula for that is negative b over 2a. If I go back to the original equation, b was negative 4, so negative b would be positive 4. And a is just 1, so 2a is 2. So the vertex is going to be, the x value for the vertex is going to be at 2. And I have to find out what the y value is going to be. So what I'll do is I'll take my equation, y equals x squared minus 4x minus 165, and I'll take the x's and replace them with 2's. So y equals 2 squared, which is 4, minus 4 times 2, which is negative 8, minus 165. And that's going to end up as, let's see, 4 minus 8 is negative 4. Negative 4 minus 165 is negative 169. So negative 169. Okay, so now I know that my graph has these two x-intercepts at negative 11 and 15. It has a y-intercept at negative 165. And has a vertex at 2 comma negative 169. And I want to set my viewing window. So if I press the window button on the calculator, I'm going to have x min and x max and x scale and then y min, y max, and y scale. And by default, it's usually set to x min at negative 10, x max at 10, x scale at 1, and then a negative 10, a positive 10 for the y min and the y max, and a 1 for the y scale. Now remember, these were the points I wanted to make sure I included in my graph. I want to make sure I include the x-intercept, the y-intercept, and the vertex. So here's what all those min and max values are about. Let's say I've got a viewing window for my graph. Let's say it's something like that. And the graph I'm going to put in actually looks something like this. It's an upward opening parabola. And I want to make sure I include the point where I have my x-intercepts. I've got two x-intercepts. One's at negative 11, one's at 15. So the lower one, the negative 11, has to be part of my graph, which means I want to have an x value that's at least negative 11 on my graph. The calculator sets it to negative 10, so I'm going to change that to a little lower than negative 11, in fact. Let's make that maybe negative 13. For the x maximum, my other x-intercept was at 15, so I want to make sure that my graph goes at least out to 15, probably a little bit more. So I'm going to set my x maximum, let's make that 17. I'll get back to the scale in a second. For the y minimum, I have to include, let's see what kind of y values I had. Well, I had a y-intercept at negative 165. The vertex was even lower. That was negative 169. So that means I want to make sure my graph goes down at least as far as negative 169, so I can include this vertex. Let's make it go a little lower. Let's make the y minimum be negative 175. And then we want to go up a little bit higher than the x-axis for the y maximum. I'm just going to leave it at 10, because if I'm going down as far as negative 175, I want to have a little bit of room above the x-axis. So I'll leave that at 10. Now, what about this thing for scale? Well, what scale does is basically it says how often you're going to have tick marks. You know, the tick marks, if I put some tick marks in here and I say each tick mark is 1, then I'm going to have my scale is going to read, my x-axis is going to read 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So for the x scale, I'm going from negative 13 up to 17. That's 30 units altogether, from negative 13 over here to 17 over here. If I think I can put in 30 tick marks, then I could leave the x scale at 1. If I'd rather have my tick marks spaced a little further apart, I could put them at maybe 2. You might even want to go as far as 5. I'll make it 2. Some of this is just a matter of opinion. But you want to make sure that you can actually, you can count your tick marks. Now, on the y scale, it's going to be more important. My y scale goes from negative 175 to 100 to 10. That's a difference of 185, which means if I leave the y scale at 1, I'm going to have 185 tick marks on that y scale. When you do that, what you end up with is just a thick line, because all of those little pixels just blend together. So if I've got that much distance, I think I might want to make my y scale 10. In other words, I'd be counting by 10s, 10, 20, 30, 40, and so on. I could even make it 20 or 25. Again, what your scale is set at is somewhat a matter of opinion or aesthetics, but make sure that you could at least use the scale and count along it rather than just have it be one thick line. Okay? So try putting that equation into your calculator. Try setting your window this way and see how it looks. And it should be something fairly decent. You might want to fool around a little bit, like I said, with the tick marks, but this should work. So the basic concept is this. When you start out with your equation, what you want to do is find your x-intercepts, your y-intercepts, and the vertex, because all of those things have to be included in your final graph. Once you've got that, go to the window menu on your calculator and make sure that you're setting your window so you include on the x-axis the lowest value for the intercept and the highest value for the x-intercept. And on your y-scale, on your y-axis, you want to include the vertex. If it's an upward opening parabola, then the vertex will be the lowest point on your graph, so that would be your y min. And you want to include some place where the y maximum would be. And you want to make sure, of course, that you show both of the axes. And then just adjust the scale so your tick marks are readable. Okay, so that should do it. Take care. I'll see you next time.